Hello students, in this session we will discuss about symmetrical T network and symmetrical pi network firstly, and then we will derive expression for characteristic impedance Z0 in case of symmetrical T network as well as in case of symmetrical pi network. So let's start firstly with the understanding of what do we mean by symmetrical T network and symmetrical pi network. So see, a two port symmetrical T network is usually it looks like this. So why do we call it a T network? We call it a T network because the three elements which are present in three branches of a given two port network is representing or is of the kind letter T in the English alphabets. And if we look at this structure, the elements are arranged in such a manner that this structure is similar to the symbol pi of mathematics. That is why such a symmetrical network is referred to as symmetrical T network, and such a symmetrical network is referred to as symmetrical pi network. Here in this case, the Z1 impedance is referred to as series arm impedance, and in case of symmetrical T network, series arm impedance is actually made up of two impedances, each of Z1 by 2. So that is why we use the word total series arm impedance. Whereas in symmetrical pi network, series arm impedance consists of a single impedance of the value Z1. So we need not write the word total series arm impedance. We can simply refer to it as series arm impedance. Even if you use the word total, it is completely all right. Here the impedance Z2 is called as shunt impedance, as it can be seen as it is connected in shunt as far as the pattern of the network is concerned. Similarly, two impedances each of the value twice Z2 are connected in shunt with each other as far as the network type or orientation is concerned. So we call Z2 as total shunt impedance. Why we call Z2 as total shunt impedance? Because twice Z2 in parallel with twice Z2 will ultimately be equivalent to only Z2. So we call Z2 to be equal to total shunt impedance. So this is how a symmetrical T network or symmetrical pi network should be firstly understood or should be interpreted. Now we will look for the derivation of characteristic impedance Z0. So see, the characteristic impedance derivation will be carried on over here. Before that, we will define or we will understand what do we mean by characteristic impedance. So look at the definition. Definition in both the cases it is same. Characteristic impedance is the input impedance Z0 when output is terminated into same impedance Z0. So I guess you may not have understood from these words exactly what do we mean by characteristic impedance. So we will look into the circuit to understand it better. So look at this. We say that Zn is input impedance for this symmetrical T network. Now, and it is terminated at Z0. Similarly, here is a pi network which is terminated at port 2 by an impedance of the value Z0. So what characteristic impedance definition is? Characteristic impedance is input impedance Z0 when output is terminated into same impedance Z0. Here it means that this Z0 will definitely be equal to Zin, and this Z0 will be definitely equal to Zin for this value to be called as characteristic impedance of this pi network, and for this value of Z0 to be called as characteristic impedance of this T network, Zin must be equal to Z0. So this is the definition of characteristic impedance. Now we will derive the value of Z0 for a given T network in terms of its inherent elements Z1 and Z2. Similarly, I will derive expression for Z0 in terms of the inherent elements of the pi network Z1 and Z2 in case of pi network. So we will go ahead in derivation. So look at this. If for derivation, the first step is you can write the Zin to be equal to, look at this, Zin can be found out in this fashion, Z1 by 2 and Z0 are in series, so they can be added. And then this addition will be in parallel with Z2. So that is why I have shown this as parallel combination. And then again, the remaining Z1 by 2 is in series, so it can be added. Look at this. To find out this Zin, we understand that these two branches are in parallel. So their parallel combination can be twice Z2 Z0 upon twice Z2 plus Z0. Then this parallel combination is in series with Z1. So it can be added over here. And then this whole thing is in parallel with twice Z2. So it is shown in parallel with twice Z2. Now we will further simplify these things and we get Zin to be equal to this much. And this is not required to be simplified further. The only thing to be noted over here is the definition of characteristic impedance says that Zin must be equal to Z0 in both the cases. So what I will do is, instead of Zin, I will substitute the value of Z0 because it is according to the definition. So once I substitute the value of Z0 instead of Zin in both the cases, I should get the further steps. So look at this. This is what I got over here. Obviously, I substituted Z0 instead of Zin over here, and this was then simplified. So I went on simplifying this thing and I ultimately reached to Z0 square is equal to Z1 square by 4 plus Z1 Z2. This ultimately gives me Z0 is equal to under root of Z1 square by 4 plus Z1 Z2. Similarly, when substituted Z0 over here, I got this, and this was simplified and I reached to Z0 is equal to under root of Z1 square Z2 square upon Z1 square by 4 plus Z1 Z2. So look at this. Formulae of characteristic impedance of T symmetrical network and formula for characteristic impedance of pi symmetrical network has a little difference. The little difference is there is this additional term. So it ultimately means that characteristic impedance in case of pi network is equal to the denominator thing involved in this formula. So denominator thing can be replaced by characteristic impedance value of the T network. So ultimately it gives me relationship between characteristic impedance of pi network and characteristic impedance of T network. So it gives me Z characteristic impedance of pi network is equal to Z1 Z2 upon characteristic impedance of T network. I hope you understood the derivation. Usually this derivation appears for 6 marks in the end sem examination. Thank you.